Most important thing in a multiplayer game is a way to join a session, and your game is no exception. That's why you need to set up a hosting and joining system for your game. By the end of this video, you'll have a fully working joining and hosting system for a peer-to-peer multiplayer game. Before we begin on the code, there are a few things we need to set up. First thing we need to do is set our game map to a listen server. To do that, go to your map, and at the top you'll see three dots. Click on them, and then under net mode, select play as listen server. Then set the player's value to 2, testing purposes. Next, in the content browser, right click and select level, then name it opening map and open it. Now, in the world settings tab, you need to set the game mode override to game mode. Then go to edit, then project settings, and under maps and mode, set the game default map to opening map, then save. Now we need to make the UI for our joining and hosting system. First, in the content browser, we want to right click and then make a new folder called UI. Then in the UI folder, we want to right click and under user interface, select widget blueprint. Then in the pop-up box, just select user widget and name it UI underscore multiplayer, then open it. First, you want to set up a canvas panel, then a border set to transparent with stretch anchors and an offset of 200 left and right, 100 top and bottom. Next, pull out a horizontal box, then pull out three vertical boxes under it set to fill. Next, drag out a text block to the middle vertical box, set it to center justification on the text, then set the font to 48, and make it say main menu. Then, pull out a spacer under the text box, set to fill, followed by a button, and a text block with font 36, saying host game. Make it center justified and name the button accordingly. Next, follow it by another spacer set to fill and another button with a text block saying join game. Center justified with a size of 36 and name the button accordingly. Then under that, you want to add a text box and another spacer set to fill 2.0. Now back in the text box, you want to set the hint text to server IP and under text style, then font, you want to set the size to 36 and all the color values to black. Then name the box server IP, then open the graph view. Now we need to code the joining and hosting system. We will start with the host game system by adding the onClicked event for our button. Next from it, we'll drag out a remove all widgets node, followed by a create session node, with player controller set using a get owning player node. Then from the onSuccess pin, drag out an open level node and set it to the name of your level. Drop down, put listen in the options field. Next, we will work on our IP field by selecting the onText committed event from the server IP box. Then from check, drag out a promote to variable node and name it value IP, then save. Next, we'll work on the join system by adding the onClicked event for the join button. Then drag out a remove all widgets node, followed by an execute console command node, the specific player pin being set to a get owning player node. Then for command, we'll drag out an append node with A being set to open space. The space is important. Then for the B, we can use the IP variable from earlier. Then, to prevent a player from locking up their game because of a wrong IP, we will drag out a delay node set to 5 seconds. Then, we will recreate the widget. Add it to the viewport. Then, you can save and compile. Back in your main menu map, we need to open up the level blueprint by going to the blueprint icon and selecting it. Then, from the event begin play event, you want to drag out a create widget node set to the UI with owning player set to a get player controller node, and drag out an add to viewport node. Finish by dragging out a set show mouse cursor node and setting it to true. Then connect it to the execute path and save and compile. You can now test it by pressing play. You'll see two windows open. On one, press host game and wait for it to load. And then in the other, for server IP, type 127.0.0.1 and then press join game and it should load. You now have a full hosting and joining menu for your multiplayer game. If you found this video helpful and want to see more weekly videos, please subscribe and ring the bell. It's free and only takes a sec. If you want to get early access to all my videos, you can check me out on Patreon. There I give access to special perks like early access to my videos and having your name in the end of my videos. If you want more videos to watch, YouTube knows you will love the video appearing now. If you have any questions or concerns, please leave them below or in my Discord. Have a good day and bye for now.